innovations are equally important for the tribal areas also. In this session, seven very interesting innovators are there. They are technological innovations. They did the innovations in services. They did the innovation in processes. I hope you would enjoy this session. I'll not take much time, as I have been given only 50 minutes. So I would request every innovator to finish within 5 to 6 minutes. Yeah. So I would request with Mr. Jawad Patel.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Jawad Patel from Hyderabad. I'm an engineering student, and let me give a quick intro. I've been working on electronics from past 13 years. That time I was in might be 6th or 7th class, a 10-year-old boy. And I used to work on automation, robotics, and all. Once I visit some remote places in Andhra Pradesh, and the scenario what I see, it's literally shivered on my spine. And then I've switched this robotics and automation domain to the problem what the people are facing off in India. So the same problem, the same topic, but different solution, the water. And the second, the domain is health. The third one is agriculture. And the final one is the energy. So this is the product called Dewdrop. It's a smart intuitive self-filling water apparatus which literally produces water out of the thin air. You people might be shocked. I'm literally producing the water out of the thin air. I used to say the people, and what you can see in this room, you can see the lights, the chairs and all, but I literally can see the 500 gallons of water in this room. So what's the process? It's a 3D printer device with the help of condensation. And as of you people might know that to condense the water vapor, we need to use some cooling agent like ammonia, CFC, R22, R13, etc. But instead of using that cooling agent, I'm using the electronic condensation process. And I have made the smart condenser with the collaboration of some chemical technology. The one atom of graphene layer is there on that. And I'll explain the working of this dewdrop. The first, the surface is it will intake the water vapor. It will intake the air and get bombarded on the smart condenser. Now, you people might be wondering, what is the smart condenser? Smart condenser is a kind of electronic condenser which will see all the necessary parameters of surrounding, and according to that, it will increase or decrease the concentration to condense the water vapor. And then the condensed water with TDS absolute zero will pass through the mineralization chamber that contain all the necessary minerals as fluorine, chlorine, iodine, and all. And I'll maintaining the TDS of this water to 150 to 173. And after getting passed through that chamber, the water gets passed through the UV treatment to kill the all unnecessary microbiological activities. So this is not more than the 12-inch device, which literally give you approx 2 liters of water, approx 1.86 liter of water in an hour. So when you're carrying the device, if you single charge the device, it will give you a backup of 8 hours. And literally, if you're carrying this dewdrop with you, you're literally carrying the 16 liters of water with you. So you don't need to go to the market, don't need to go to anywhere to buy the 22 rupees water bottle or something. You just need to carry this device. And the surprising thing is that if we produce this device in mass, so the cost will be less than 2,000. That's it. So as we know, the water scarcity is the biggest issue in India or around the globe. So the version 2.0 of this device will produce 1,000 liters of water in a day. That's it. Then this is my second innovation. You might have people been heard about the smart helmet. Actually, I have designed in 2010. This is the smart helmet kit which keep you safe and your vehicle secure. Now people are not wearing the helmet, so this thing will won't let you start the vehicle if you won't wear this helmet. And there's lots of features are there, like the security. If you consume alcohol or something, so it will you won't allow to ride your vehicle or something. And this the thing is called solarius. You haven't find this word solarius in the dictionary because it's created by me only. This is a solar power vehicle. On a single charge, it will give you the backup of 100 kilometers. So you don't need to prefer this petrol or something. The third one is the AgriTech. As of you know, the many people sitting over here, so different people have different capacity to consume water to quench their thirst. Some people take one glass of water, some of them you take two glass to quench their thirst. So the same process I'm applying to the agriculture process. For the array of this a plant, according to the need of the plant, I'm going to provide the manure and water by this device. So it will, what will happen? The productivity of the plant will gonna increase by 10x. The plant which will give you the one fruit, it will, by using of this device, it will give you the 10 fruits. So this is the second technology for agriculture. And so I conclude the thing. And so the basic structure of mine is that I used to helping other people with the help of technology, with the help of electronics, simple. And I'm looking to launch this product by some incubation center or something. So that's it. And I think I've covered my speech in 5 minutes. So ek award to banta hai.
Thank you, Jawad. You know, we should learn from him. In fact, within 5 minutes, he has shown many technologies and demonstrated that he's a serial innovator. And definitely, he needs investment from the corporate sector. Thank you very much. Now I would request Mr. Arup Datta.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm thankful to the management of PIC and Dr. Mashelkar to give me this opportunity. This innovation is about how you can rapidly intervene into a disaster situation or into injury or personal wounds like chronic wounds in an aging patient or diabetic patient who has a leg ulcer, cannot drive to the hospital every 3 days. So how do you help them in a home setting, because aging is a big problem in future. Now, don't we all wish that in case of acute emergencies, wounds, we have something better than handkerchief in our pockets? At the moment, there is nothing in that we carry. We carry smartphone. We carry water bottle, a small one. But we don't carry anything in our car, in our scooter, or in office, other than traditional thing which is not designed for a situation which is more than a Band-Aid or a Bernol or a Dettol. So this innovation is about that. In addition to that, we have a large number of accidents, probably the largest number in India. Largest number of burn cases in rural, most probably 80%, which is not reported. These are all reported cases. Almost 1 million of both road accidents where the injury happens, not the death I'm talking about, and the burn cases. In addition to that, 10 times more is the diabetic ulcer patients who are in home. And every time for simple dressing, they have to go to the center for which they have to depend on somebody. And this problem is going to increase because aging is increasing, diabetic as an epidemic is increasing, therefore diabetic foot ulcer is going to increase, whether we like it or not. So we have to devise something. We have to devise something so that a rapid and convenient factor and the cost factor all can be taken care of. Now this is our team, but I will cut it short. It's all full of technical people like us. There are some, at the end of the day, there are people who has done this biomedical device entire cycle. There are mentors. Okay, wound prevalence numbers are very big in the world, but this is the spectrum. Most often wounds are created in the hospital itself because surgical need is there. And that is a fixed situation. Can we fit into that segment as well? Because there's the money to be made. Well, by the way, this is social, but not that it has to be charitable. So there are a number of kind of wounds in the round, but diabetic foot ulcer and the hospital-like situations are the major one. Now, this is a slide which actually says that how the wound devices in the market is going to change over future, as well as what are the major players. So the important thing is that how do we beat these Goliath? Like these multinationals are there and they are making products which are very costly, which are not affordable for sure. And more often, unfortunately, in India, there is hardly any indigenous technology other than a couple of things that has come on CLRI. They are also not very affordable, but then where they're indigenous. So all the products which come are hardly affordable in rural sector. So how do we take this product to a rural sector? So in order to cover all this kind of clinical wounds, we have to create a common device. And each clinical need is unique. Some of them are infected. Some of them are bleeding. Some of them are chronic. Some of them are deep and deep cuts. There we have to actually do the stitching or something else. Creating a device for which can actually help any situation is a common idea that we have challenged ourselves with, because we come from pure technical background. So the concept here is to use body's own material. Their body consists of certain kind of biopolymers, and there are engineering principles behind these materials. We are not talking of biology over here. We are talking simple engineering of the construction of how the body is made. Can we use those principles from nature to heal the wound or to cover the wound, to first aid the wound to begin with, and of course therapeutic angle much later. So the idea is that take something we call extracellular matrix, which holds our body cells together, which is collagenous matrix, and make a formulation out of it that gels in situ when we apply it on the wound. So irrespective of kind of wound, USFDA and other agencies has declared this material suitable, and there are multiple products in the Western country and they are exorbitantly costly. For example, a chronic wound cost anything bit per wound, it will cost $10,000. Now, how do we reduce that cost in India using such technologies? So what we have done is these are the benefits of that. For example, we cover through a single device widest possible type of wounds. Then it is very quick and easy to use. Any layman can use it. Then it has multiple use. Normally a device is used once. You use it on a single patient on a single occasion. Can it be used on multiple patients, on multiple occasions? Because sometimes disaster requires that. Accidents require that. There's not a single thing. So every time you open the wrap, vital time is lost, applied, and all this thing is done at the moment only by medical professionals. Laymen cannot do it. So we thought of very simple spray kind of device. So these are the innovations. This is the spray, and this is the filler. When the cavity is created, a deep wound is there, we have to fill with this material. Otherwise, we simply have to cover it like a film, like Band-Aid, but created in situ. We spray it, and the film is formed, covers the wound from further infection, further injury, stop the bleeding, and this gives enough time for the patient to go to doctor, because sometimes this delay can be from 15 minutes to a few hours. Now, the important thing to be noticed here, we are not promoting it as a therapeutic device. We are promoting it as a first aid. Important thing is that golden hour has to be maintained. A wound should not get infected. It should reduce the pain. The victim himself should be able to deploy it. Victim should be able to deploy it in odd places. A spray cannot work on the back. So there has to be design feature, ergonomic features, which are much smarter than the ordinary spray. Normally you can't see through the containers of the spray because it's metal. So we try to make it transparent as well, because you know how much is left. So you are ready for any eventuality, whether it's a household situation or whether it is a disaster ultimately. So these are the market. This of course has a B2B appeal as well as B2C appeal. So first we have decided to go to B2B because there has to be piloting of it. There are safety issues involved. So then we can graduate to the B2C. So this is our business model, which largely talks about how do we pilot and then we graduate to the larger scale. And how do we adopt the situation to the poorest of the poor in the most remote part of the country? That, by the way, it can be next door in the urban sector. Poor guy can be anywhere. So how do we make it possible for him? At the moment, current devices, the benchmark devices that we have internally, it can reduce the cost straight away 10 times, thanks to Dr. Masigla. But we have been doing it last 2 years. We know this figure. And in fact, compared to the import, it can be almost 50 to 100 times more. So this is our business model. The idea we have taken is that if this bottle can be available in remotest of the part of the villages, in remote part, the dhabas will have this bottle. Can we use the same business model which is quite unheard of in medical device, which is largely based on high value, low volume principle, so that the rich can afford it. Can we make it low, high volume, but low value? So therefore, there is a very unique business model of ours, similar to FMCG, and we can cut down the cost to pennies. Thank you. This is our innovation. I hope I, by the way, I must thank to invite me, because it was very humbling to see the tribal and rural innovation. We, I must frankly accept, we city slickers think that we are doing greatest thing. It is not. This is the eye opener to me. Thank you very much for this opportunity.
Thank you, Mr. Datta, for excellent presentation. Now, Ms. Dhanushri Chauhan from I Love Composer.
Good afternoon. It's an honor to present and express my views over here on how teaching composting in schools and doing composting at home is a very impactful way of connecting our youth to the natural world and our day-to-day issues. So in nature, there is no waste. Everything is getting transformed. Everything is getting recycled. So it's connected. I wanted to connect children to the concept, the urban children, to the concept of regenerating things, of the concept of living soil. So I founded I Love Composting. So composting, when you're doing composting at home, it begins a small cycle of bringing nature into your house. It, a simple thing like kitchen waste becomes a resource that we are using to create living soil. Otherwise, this resource goes to the landfills, it goes to the rivers, and it becomes a highly impactful pollutant. So what is the problem? The problem is that in our growing years, we are taught that managing waste is not my problem, it is somebody else's problem. So we grow up to become a very highly educated homemaker who will tie all the unsegregated waste in a plastic bag and just throw it in the river or to be taken to the landfills. Or I'll become an industrialist who will be releasing wastewaters in rivers. And it is going to affect everything. It is going to affect the rurals also. Then I will become a builder who will be dumping all the waste in mangroves. And or I just become, to connect to nature, I'm just a tourist who is littering around when I go to Himalayas. So what could be the solution? What could be the change that could be got? So it could be done through the help of children. We could bring this change about in the children. So we designed two things for this. We did the study material through awareness camps. We can teach children right from beginning that we don't have to create waste, we have to waste less, and also we designed a composting bin. So in the study material, the thing is that we connect children through our workshops to the native seeds, higher loom seeds, to the insects that are found in the compost. Then we also direct them towards growing organic food. In this way, the inhibition of having insects in their homes is also less, or the inhibition that, okay, my composting bin will smell, will it smell, how will I operate it? So all these things are tackled during our awareness sessions. And to complete this entire thing, we designed a prototype, a small composting unit, which even small children and everyone, the elders and everyone, can use it efficiently in their homes. Now we are taking it step further by we have designed a composting bin which will be roto molded and which can be which is more durable. So how can we implement composting more effectively? Is it the work of only government? No, we need active participation from the communities also to take this forward. In India, according to our living style, 70% of the waste generated is wet kitchen waste, and if this is and only 5% of it is composted. So if we compost at least some portion of it, and instead of sending waste to the villages, if we can send the compost generated to the villages, it is going to make a very big radical change. And I would also like Amruta to explain about the next, there is always entrepreneurial thing which drives me, okay, how can I make it better, how can I reach out to more people, because this is a global problem, it can be also implemented not only over here in cities, it can be replicated in other places. How we can involve more students to teach composting, how we can create more entrepreneurs who can teach composting and also sell the composting units. So we have designed a model around it, and also we have designed a composting bin. Please help me, Amrita.
Thank you very much. As innovators, we were told to pitch for what our requirements or in terms of help we would require. The help today that we ask from you is that connect us to school to apply the project-based learning approach. Now, what is project-based learning approach is that we implement these projects, the composting units in schools, and thereby the teachers themselves, train the teachers as well through teachers training program on how to teach composting as well as how to do composting, and thereby they take it forward, and thus the theory learnings for these students comes into practice. So thus help us spread this bug of composting. We have diligently worked on designing a unique study material for children which is waiting to be printed and published. We would require your help to publish into a booklet format in English as well as other regional language so that we can ask volunteers from other cities to join this composting revolution. Organizations which can help us take up these activities and contribute in terms of man hours to volunteer for these teaching programs in various schools in urban as well as rural areas. We have also researched and designed another individual bin, as Tanashree rightly said, which is adhering to the product features, its durability, its uses, and its operational ease. So this design has been kept in mind with the product features which can be exported. So we are looking for exporting a Make in India initiative which can be exported to international markets. So we look for mentoring to enter the global markets. We also look for marketing strategies. We also look for marketing strategies to penetrate into domestic markets and international markets, like I said. We look for legal advisory help for organization and structuring and classification to make this work of ours sustainable. Again, the Pune Municipal Corporation has made it mandatory for household societies to do composting, to process their waste in their own premises, the construction, the buildings that have been built after the year 2000. But a survey done by the NGO Janvani is concluded that only 40% of these societies actually have functional units, functional composting units. So we would like to ask to network us and get us connected with real estate sector so that we can become a solution provider for individual decentralized home composting. Provide us with guidance for marketing, communication network, and implement these ideas of social innovation and how we can avail subsidy through government schemes. Also as a woman entrepreneur on education, manufacturing, and expanding the reach of composting. I would just like to conclude with a small thank you, and thank you PIC and all the organizers. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Now we have youngest innovator, Shubh Dholakia.
Hello, good afternoon, all over present here. I am Shubh Dholakia from Rajkot, Gujarat. And my project, first of all, I am thankful to PIC for giving us a golden opportunity to attend this national conference on social innovation, and NIF for giving us such a golden height to my innovation. My project is detachable device for the bicycle, enabling user to ride with one leg and also attached a hand-operated portable side stand. That's my device. This is the detachable device, and this is the hand-operated portable side stand. Generally, handicapped people uses three-wheeler cycle or four-wheeler scooters. But by using that, they feel as they are different creatures in the society. So I thought, why don't they use two-wheeler cycle? Till today, they used two-wheeler cycle with their sticks to give a half pedal. And now they would use by the spring made by me. Why PH people cannot ride a bicycle? They can. For this, I came to a solution. By using my both devices, that is detachable device and hand-operated portable side stand, they can also ride a bicycle. Detachable device, it is a retrofitting device which is attached to a crankset of a bicycle and can enable the user to ride using one leg. And hand-operated portable side stand. Hand-operated portable side stand is fitted below the carrier of the bicycle. It provides support to rider as their second leg. As uses of detachable device, handicapped person has to give a half pedal, and half pedal will be given by this device. And hand-operated portable side stand. We have provided an additional hand-operated system which is attached to the portable side stand. When PH person will pull the handle below the main handle of the bicycle, when they will pull the handle 180 degree, the wheel will come down, and when they gain the balance, they have to push the handle and the wheel 180 degree, and the wheel will come up. So the wheel doesn't disturb them in cycling. Advantages of both devices can be attached on either side of the bicycle as per the need. It does not need any change in the main mechanism of the bicycle. Any blacksmith of village or any common man can easily attach this both devices. Its operation is very easy, and as its handle is between main seat and it does not need any maintenance. And both devices can be attached on any common bicycle. Additional advantages of side stand. As PH people doesn't have the second leg, and this side stand provides support as their second leg. They can use it when they start a ride, at traffic post, at any time of emergency, and at a parking place. By using this side stand, they can get confidence to ride bicycle. They also feel by riding this bicycle, they can feel as they are common person in the society, because nowadays they use three-wheeler cycle, so they doesn't feel that they are common people. Conclusion, with the help of detachable device and hand-operated portable side stand, any handicapped person whose one leg is lost or they are injured can easily ride bicycle with their one leg. This were second last year, 2014, in which I got award from NIF by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Thank you. Please, I have a video, so please watch that video. There was a young boy who was riding the bicycle. Here you can see this device. And here he gave the half pedal, and half pedal was given by this device. You can see from the other side. Here he is giving a half pedal, and half pedal is coming by itself. So this was my device. And other side, there is a side stand which gives it support. Okay, so this was my project. Thank you. And I strongly request to corporate officials to give their valuable support and introduce this innovation in the society. Thank you.
Thank you, Shubh. Now, Yogesh Malkhare.
नमस्कार. माझं नाव योगेश मालखरे. मी पी आय सी ग्रुपचं आभार मानतो की त्यांनी मला इथं बोलायला संधी देत आहेत. मी गेली 2007 पासून समाजसेवेचा काम करायचा प्रयत्न करत आहे. यशवंतराव मेमोरियल हॉस्पिटल पिंपरी चिंचवड येथील गरीब रुग्णांना, जिथे ट्रीटमेंट कमी पैशामध्ये होते अशा रुग्णांना जेवणाला पैसे नसतात अशा लोकांना मी 2007 ते 2014 1,00,000 रुग्णांना मोफतमध्ये मी जेवण दिलेलं आहे. याचबरोबर अशा रुग्णांना जेवण, ब्लड, ॲम्ब्युलन्स, सी टी स्कॅन मी ह्या सगळ्या सुविधा आजपर्यंत पुरवलेल्या आहेत. राजीव गांधी योजनेअंतर्गत या सुविधा आता मिळाल्यानंतर मी आता बाहेर समाजामध्ये ज्या काही अजून अडचणी आहेत त्यांना न्याय देण्याचा प्रयत्न करतो आहे. मी एक स्वातंत्र्य सैनिकाचा नातू आहे आणि देशावर माझं प्रेम आहे. आपण गणपती उत्सव सगळेजण खूप आनंदाने मनवतो. लोकमान्य टिळकांनी ज्यावेळेस जो उत्सव चालू केला त्यावेळेस ती गरज होती आणि आता गरज आहे ती आपल्यापासून आनंदाने वंचित असलेल्या मुलांना जवळ घेण्याची. मी गणपती उत्सव गरीब झोपडीतल्या एका मुलाला 10 दिवस घरी आणून 10 दिवस त्याला आनंद देऊन मी अशा प्रकारे गणपती उत्सव साजरी करतो. आपण नेहमीच म्हणतो भारत माझा देश आहे आणि सारे भारतीय माझे बांधव आहेत. मग आपल्याला जातीभेद कुठून आला? म्हणून मी यावर्षी अरबाज खान या नावाच्या गरीब मुलाला मी घरी आणून 10 दिवस गणपती साजरी केला. आपण पाहतोय की आपण सॉरी पुढे गेलो माग 2 नंबर. प्रत्येक भिकारी काही भिकारी नसतो. त्याचं एक उदाहरण मी तुम्हाला देतो. आपल्यासमोर जो फोटो दिसतोय त्या पहिल्या फोटोमध्ये मी त्यांच्याशी बोलतोय आणि दुसऱ्या फोटोमध्ये ते आता कसे आहेत. यांचं नाव आहे डॉक्टर शहा. तुळशीबाग पुणे इथे भीक मागत होते. त्यांना मी भेटलो, त्यांच्या अडचणी विचारलं आणि मी त्यांना आश्रममध्ये ॲडमिट केलं. या गोष्टीला आता 4 महिने झाले. ते व्यवस्थित त्या आश्रममध्ये सगळ्या पेशंटला तपासत आहेत. त्यांना आता 10,000 रुपये पेमेंट चालू आहे. त्यांच्या भावाने त्यांना प्रॉपर्टीतून हकललं म्हणून ते अशा अवस्थेमध्ये आज आले आणि बायकोही म्हटले की तुझ्याकडे आता प्रॉपर्टी नाही म्हणून ती सोडून गेली. त्याच्यामुळे ते अशा अवस्थेमध्ये भीक मागत होते. त्यांना आता पण योग्य पर्याय दिलेला आहे. मी शहरातल्या बेघर आणि मनोरुग्ण या लोकांसाठी मी काम करतोय. आपण बघता घाणेरड्या अवस्थेमध्ये आपल्याला लोक नेहमीच दिसतात रोडवर आणि आपल्याला वाईट वाटतं. वाईट वाटत नाही अशी गोष्ट नाही आहे, पण नेमकं काय करायचं हे माहिती नसतं. म्हणून मी आधी यांच्याजवळ गेलो, यांच्याशी प्रेमाने वागलो, त्यांच्याशी बोललो आणि हे खूप छान बोलतात. काहींना बोलता येत नाही पण त्यांचे हावभाव कळतात की यांना काय हवं आहे नेमकं. म्हणून मी अशा लोकांसाठी काम सुरू केलेलं आहे ज्यांना आपण काय आहोत आणि कसं वागतो याचं भान नसतं. अशा उघड्या अवस्थेमध्ये आपल्याला ते फिरताना दिसत आहेत, मग यांचं काय आणि यांना कोण बघणार? म्हणून मी एक स्माईल प्लस सोशल फाउंडेशन ही संस्था 2007 पासून काम करतो, पण संस्था रजिस्ट्रेशन मी आत्ता केली कारण की याच्यासाठी आपल्याला बरंच काम लागणार आहे पुढे. म्हणून मी संस्था आता रजिस्ट्रेशन केली आहे. नेक्स्ट हा फोटो दिसतोय. तो पहिल्या फोटोमध्ये जो दिसतोय तोच शेवटच्या फोटोमध्ये आहे. याचं नाव आहे व्यंकटेश. आपण नेहमीच अशा लोकांना बघून हसतो, पुढे जातो किंवा काहीतरी देऊन पैसे देऊन पण पुढे निघून जातो. पण याला आपण जवळ घेतलं, याला मी ॲडमिट केलं. या 1.5 महिन्यामध्ये याने याचं नाव सांगितलं. याचं नाव गाव आहे तामिळनाडू. तामिळनाडूमध्ये आम्ही पोलिसांना कॉन्टॅक्ट केला. तिथे मिसिंग आहे का पाहिलं, पण तिथे कुठेही मिसिंग नव्हता. परत अजून फोन करून वारंवार तिथल्या अधिकाऱ्यांना रिक्वेस्ट करून मी एक माझा नंबर देऊन ठेवला. एक दिवशी मला फोन आला, व्यंकटेश आमच्या तिथं 8 वर्षापासून मिसिंग आहे आणि तो जिवंत आहे का? म्हटलं असं का विचारताय? म्हणजे त्याची आई रोज विचारते आम्हाला 8 वर्षापासून माझा मुलगा मिळाला का. तर या व्यंकटेश नायडूला 8 वर्षानंतर मी त्याच्या आईकडे पाठवलं आणि सांगायला आनंद होतोय की मला याला सोडायला माझ्याकडे पैसे नव्हते तामिळनाडूला, कारण मी एकटाच खूप जास्त मदत नाही करू शकत. तर मला याच्या बहिणीचा फोन आला की व्यंकटेश कुठे आहे. म्हटलं पुण्यामध्ये. मी 2 तासात पुण्यात पोचते आहे. त्याची बहीण त्याला घ्यायला आली. आम्ही जेव्हा मेंटल हॉस्पिटलमधून त्याला बाहेर आणलं, गाडीत बसवतो आणि विचारलं गाडी कोणाची आहे, तामिळनाडू दिसते. म्हणजे ही व्यंकटेशची गाडी आहे, स्कॉर्पिओ. 160 एकरचा मालक आहे तो. लोकमतला बातमी पण आली होती, आपण वाचली असेल कदाचित. नेक्स्ट ही महिला खेड माहिती आहे आपल्याला, राजगुरुनगर. स्वातंत्र्य सैनिकांचं गाव, आपले देशभक्त. त्यांच्या गावामध्ये 3 वर्षापासून कपडे न घालता ही महिला फिरती आहे. कल्पना करा काय वाटत असेल बघणाऱ्याला आणि या महिलेला. पर्याय नाही आहे लोकांकडे, वाईट सगळ्यांना वाटतं, म्हणून स्माईल प्लस सोशल फाउंडेशन यांच्यासाठी आता काम करत आहे. मला जेव्हा कळलं की महिला अशी फिरती आहे, रविवार होता, मी तिला ते घेतलं, आधी कपडे घातले. आज आपण बघतोय की सगळ्या जाती धर्माचे मोर्चे निघतात, आंदोलन निघतात, मला आदर आहे त्यांच्याबद्दल. पण अशा लोकांचं काय की त्याला जाताही माहिती नाही आणि नावं पण माहिती नाही आहे. तर यासाठी आपण आता काम करतो आहे. या महिलेला मी आणलं, हिला ॲडमिट केलं आहे. फेसबुक मी ही पोस्ट केली होती, 2 लाख लोकांनी या पोस्टला पाहिलेलं आहे, सॉरी 22 लाख. तर अशा प्रकारे नेक्स्ट तर आपण काम करतो आहे. पण अडचण अशी आहे, मेंटल हॉस्पिटल महाराष्ट्रामध्ये फक्त 4 आहेत, ठाणे, रत्नागिरी, नागपूर आणि पुणे. आणि यांची संख्या हजारो आहे, बेवारस हजारो लोक आहेत जी रोडो पडून आहेत. 4 मेंटल हॉस्पिटल, पुण्याचं उदाहरण जर दिलं तर 4 मेंटल हॉस्पिटल जे आहेत, पुण्याचा एरिया आहे तो 600 किलोमीटर येतो. 600 किलोमीटरवर जर कोणी मेंटल असेल तर त्याला पुणे मेंटल हॉस्पिटलला आणलं जातं. पण याला आणणार कोण हे पोलिसांचं काम आहे. पण ते तरी अशा पेशंटला किती लोकांना आणणार? आपण एक सामाजिक भावनेने आपणही काही तर मदत करायला पाहिजे म्हणून आम्ही हे काम करतो आहे. पण दुर्दैवाची गोष्ट अशी आहे, तुम्हाला 2 फोटो दिसत आहेत, एका जाळीमध्ये कुत्र्याला घेऊन जात आहेत, दुसऱ्या जाळीमध्ये त्याची गाडी आहे. कुत्र्यांसाठी कमिटी आहे, समिती आहे, त्यांच्यासाठी स्टाफ आहे. जिवंत माणसासाठी दुर्दैव आहे, महाराष्ट्रात एकही ॲम्ब्युलन्स नाही आहे. मी या माणसाला ॲटो रिक्षामध्ये घेऊन जातो, ते पण डबल भाडं देऊन. तो म्हटला मला गाडी धुवावं लागेल परत. पण तो माणूस आहे ना, माणसासाठी नाही आणि कुत्र्यांसाठी आहे. आणि अशा हजारो बेगोर लोकांचं काय करणार? आपण आहे त्या माणसांना आनंद कसा मिळेल, कसं डेव्हलपमेंट होता येईल तेवढंच बघतो, आणि ज्याला नाही आहे त्याचं काय? याच्यासाठी मी आज तुमच्याजवळ आलेलो आहे की याला आपल्याला महाराष्ट्रामधून प्रत्येक निराधारांना आपल्याला आधार द्यायचा आहे. 4 मेंटल हॉस्पिटलमध्ये आपल्याला 4 ॲम्ब्युलन्स उभा करायच्या आणि त्यासाठी आपल्याला स्टाफ उभा करायचा आहे. याच्यासाठी खूप खर्च येणार आहे. मी ICICI बँकेमध्ये होम लोनची कामं करतो, त्याच्यामुळे मी महिन्याला जास्त कमवू शकत नाही. तरी मी महिन्याला 1,25,00,000 रुपये मी सध्या खिशातून खर्च करतो आहे. माझी मिसेस इथे बसलेली आहे, रमा मालखरे, ती सकाळमध्ये जॉब करते. तिलाही माहिती नाही की तिचं ATM कुठल्या कलरचं आहे. तिची मला एवढी साथ आहे म्हणून मी आज तुमच्या इथे उभा आहे. तर अशा प्रकारे आपल्याला महाराष्ट्रातील लोकांना एकत्र आणायचं आहे. 4 ॲम्ब्युलन्स घ्यायच्या आहेत, याच्यासाठी आपल्याला 60 लाख रुपये एक स्टार्टअप करायसाठी लागणार आहे आणि महिन्याला 1,60,000 रुपये याचा स्टाफ आणि ऑफिसचं रेंट आणि डिझेल हा खर्च येणार आहे. तर एका माणसाला त्याचं पुनर्जीवन करण्यासाठी आपल्याला फक्त 3,200 रुपये खर्च येतो आहे. तर मला वाटत नाही की हे आपल्या सगळ्यांच्या मदतीने खूप अवघड आहे. तर तुम्ही याच्यावर एक माणुसकीने विचार करावा ही सगळ्यांना विनंती. परत एकदा PIC ने मला ही संधी दिली, प्रशांतजींचे मी मनापासून धन्यवाद मानतो. आणि मला माझे मित्र आहेत जे रवीजी, त्यांनी इथपर्यंत येण्याची संधी दिली आणि तुम्ही सगळ्यांनी माझे 2 शब्द ऐकले. धन्यवाद. जय हिंद.
थँक्यू व्हेरी मच. बहुत अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं आप. नाउ द तान्या.
गुड आफ्टरनून लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन. आई एम तान्या इचापोरिया एंड आई रिप्रेजेंट रेड डॉट्स फाउंडेशन विच इज सेफ सिटी. वी टॉक अबाउट सेक्शुअल वायलेंस, सेक्शुअल हॅरेसमेंट, बट वी डू नॉट टॉक अबाउट इट इन द ओपन. इट हॅपन्स टू ईच अँड एव्हरी वन ऑफ अस. वी आयदर एक्सपीरियन्स इट पर्सनली ओर वी विटनेस इट. Globally, it's experienced everywhere. 1 in 3 women are sexually harassed all over the world. In India, we don't have the numbers because we do not report it. Of these women, only 80% of them don't report it. 20% report, 80% don't. So we do not get a true picture of what is sexual harassment, what is sexual violence. And in today's scenario, with media, with all our smartphones and technology, it is something that is on the rise. We not only focus on women, we focus on children, because sexual harassment starts at the age of 3 years. Children who do not understand. Yes, we talk about good touch and bad touch, but that's about it. So what do we do at Safe City? We encourage people to fill up reports which make them feel safe and comfortable, which protects their identity, and we plot the place or the and the issue on a map. So we have crowd maps, which is online, available to everyone. They fill up these reports, and then it's marked as a hotspot. So that place, wherever this incident has happened, is marked as a hotspot. These reports we share not only with local communities, MLAs, but also the police. Everyone wants their local place, their city, to be the best. So this is a way to help people not only be aware, but also open up and talk about issues that have happened. Each of us sitting here would have definitely experienced some form of sexual violence or harassment. When we talk of scalability and impact, we not only focus in India, we're working with Nigeria, Cameroon, Nepal, and these are places where, similar to India, they have the same issues. We work with 3 police forces as of now, the Mumbai police, the Goa police, and the Delhi police. We also work with communities, 12 communities across Delhi and Mumbai, making people aware of what is sexual harassment, helping them to file FIR reports, helping them to go to the police station, maybe even twice, thrice, or 6 times if it means taking them there, and helping them out to sort the issue out. We conduct workshops, and we've trained close to about 9,000 people, not only children, but also our youth and corporates. What we are looking from you is partnerships to help us tackle this huge issue that we have, to help us educate not just women and children, not just in the rural areas and urban areas, but also our children, the future of our tomorrow. We also would look at mentoring, helping us to scale up, and financial strategy. Thank you.
Now the last innovator of this session is Mr. Nirav Mandliwal.
Namaste to all. First of all, I would like to thank PIC and Mashalkar sir for starting with such an innovative program. Sir, मैं भी SOG का स्टूडेंट हूँ और हर बार आपकी फ़ोटो देख के मैं पढ़ रहा था, आज आपके सामने मुझे बोलने का मौका मिल रहा है. आई प्रेजेंट दी रिप्रेजेंट दी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कॉल्ड डोनेट लाइफ. वी वर्क फॉर द कैडेवर ऑर्गन डोनेशन. लेट्स लुक एट द प्रॉब्लम एंड द वाई द कैडेवर ऑर्गन डोनेशन इज नीडेड इन इंडिया. बाय एन एस्टिमेट देर आर अबाउट 20 लाख पीपल सफरिंग फ्रॉम किडनी फेलियर एंड 2 lakh such people are added to these figures every year. There is the same situation in the failure of liver, heart, pancreas, eyes, etc. Around 5 lakh people, just 5 lakh, because of this problem, 5 lakh people die every year because of non-availability of organs. If we look at the figure, then against the requirement of 2 lakh kidneys, only 4,000 kidneys are transplanted. That is just 2%. Against the requirement of 1 lakh liver, only 500 liver are being transplanted. Against the requirement of 50,000 heart, only 50 heart are being transplanted. Against the requirement of 1 lakh cornea, only 25,000 is transplanted. Looking to the figure of the world, then the cadaver organ ratio in Spain is 34%. In USA, it's 26%. In Sweden, it's 15%. In UK, it's 17%. And in India, with so much of population, it's just 0.5%. The major problem is the ignorance and the lack of awareness about cadaver organ donation and the religious myths and the belief. Fear in people's mind about organ donation and the ratio of the organ donor registration is very low. कोई भी धर्म में ये नहीं कहा गया है कि किसी की जिंदगी बचाना पाप है. ऑर्गन डोनेशन करना पाप नहीं है, पर हर धर्म में ये कहता है कि ऑर्गन बेचना पाप है. About Donate Life, then Donate Life is a non-profit organization established for the purpose of cadaver organ donation and prevention of ever-increasing disease of kidney failure across the country. The organization is committed to serve humanity without any commercial motive. With the ever-increasing number of patients suffering from kidney failure and end-stage liver and heart disease, our drive is twofold. First, to make people aware and educate them about the disease and its prevention. And second, to provide them with a new lease of life through cadaver organ donation. Our vision is no live donation, only cadaveric donation. Agar kisi ki kidney fail ho jati hai, unke parivar mein se unko koi ek bar kidney deta hai, par fir se wo kidney agar fail ho jati hai, to main aapse puchta hu, unko jeene ka hak hai ke nahi hai. Unko jeene ka hak hai. और वो हक सिर्फ उनको कैडेवर ऑर्गन डोनेशन की वजह से ही मिल सकता है. व्हाट डोनेट लाइफ डज, इट क्रिएट्स द अवेयरनेस अबाउट द कैडेवर ऑर्गन डोनेशन, प्लेज अ रोल ऑफ ब्रिज फॉर मेकिंग कैडेवर ऑर्गन डोनेशन अ सक्सेस. इट काउंसिल्स विद द ब्रेनडेड पेशेंट्स फैमिली मेंबर्स. वी नेटवर्क विद द ऑर्गन प्रोक्योरिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दैट इज IKDRC इन अहमदाबाद एंड ZTCC इन मुंबई, टू एक्सेप्ट द डोनेशन ऑफ हार्ट. We coordinate with the police department for the arrangement of the green corridor. We coordinate with the post-mortem department, because at the night around 3 a.m. also, we go and ask the post-mortem department to do the post-mortem of the patient who have donated the organs. We stay with the family till the last ritual of the brain dead patient is been done. We do the counseling with the organ failure patients itself, educate them with various policies of the government. And we constantly do the liaisoning with the government to frame favorable policies. The law that permits organ donation is HOTA. Who can be a donor? Anyone, whoever is brain dead can be a donor. Any man or woman can donate their organs. But a patient suffering from end-stage organ failure can receive the organ, but the medical condition will decide the priority. The donor's family are never allowed to select the recipient. Social and financial status are never the deciding factor in cadaver organ donation. To motivate, now if we look at the problems, then the solutions to the problems, then the first solution is to motivate people, the normal human beings, to donate the organs after brain dead and to spread the awareness. In this thing, the transparency is of much importance. हम जब से डोनेट लाइफ में काम कर रहे, किस दिन किनको ऑर्गन मिला, कौन सी हॉस्पिटल से ऑर्गन प्रोक्योर किया, कौन सी हॉस्पिटल में ऑर्गन ट्रांसप्लांट किया, वो किनको मिला, कौन से सिटी का वो आदमी है, वो सारी डिटेल्स अभी तक की हमारी वेबसाइट के ऊपर कोई भी देख सकता है. सेमिनार्स है, एग्जीबिशंस, स्ट्रीट प्लेस, प्रेजेंटेशंस, टॉक शोज, ये सारी चीज करने से ही अवेयरनेस आ पाएगी. नाउ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट सॉल्यूशन इज द ग्रीन कॉरिडोर. आई विल शो यू अ वीडियो कि एक हार्ट जब ट्रांसप्लांट करने का होता है तो उस टाइम पे कितने लोगों की टीम हम लोग को काम में लगती है. देयर इज अ टीम ऑफ 500 डेडिकेटेड वॉलेंटियर्स हु वर्क्स टूगेदर टू मेक दिस हार्ट ट्रांसप्लांट अ सक्सेस, विच इंक्लूड्स द 200 पुलिस जवान हु वुड बी डूइंग ड्यूटी ऑन द रोड फॉर अ सक्सेसफुल हार्ट ट्रांसफर.
Bye.
फ्रेंड सूरत पुलिस एक ही पुलिस डिपार्टमेंट है जिसने ऑफिशियल एक नोटिफिकेशन बाहर निकाला है कि जब भी कभी भी हार्ट ट्रांसप्लांट करना होगा तो उसमें 200 पुलिस लगेगी, उसका रूट क्या होगा. सो आई एम प्राउड ऑन सूरत पुलिस के उन्होंने भी ऐसा एक नोटिफिकेशन निकाला है. बिकॉज हार्ट ट्रांसप्लांट एक ऐसी चीज है विच इज कॉल्ड रेस अगेंस्ट द टाइम. Now, if we look at the social, the scalability and the impact, then we have educated more than 5 lakh people, 40% heart, kidney and liver transplant in Gujarat, and 25% heart transplant in Maharashtra is done with the help of Donate Life. The then Honorable Chief Minister of Gujarat, Anandiben Patel, herself pledged for the organ donation after her brain dead, and she set an example by donating her elder sister's organ 6 months ago. This is the figure about the organ donation done by us. If you look then, years by years, the figure has been increasing. Since 2006 to 2014, we were working on an individual basis. And after 2014, we set up an NGO that is Donate Life. And I am happy to say, in these years, we are able to give 400 people a new life and a vision across the India by cadaver organ donation. You would be glad to know, last night we did the 8th heart transplant from Gujarat to Maharashtra, and the heart was transplanted from a 26 years boy from Bhavnagar, and it was transplanted into a 47 years old person in Kolhapur of Maharashtra, Balkishan Pandurang Kholgare. What is the need of financial and other requirements? Donate Life bears the expense for keeping the brain dead patients in good condition before the cadaver organ donation. Different tests are to be done, such as renal functional tests, liver functional tests, UCG, 2D echo, and angiography to know the quality of the organ, because we can't give a bad organ to any patient. The transportation expense of cadaver organ donor's body from one city to other state is also borne by Donate Life. The major expenses are awareness program, the printing materials, awareness video, and the administrative expense, because the office of Donate Life and the organization is working 24/7 for this cause with a toll-free number also. And in coming days, we are now going to set up the skin, bone, and tissue bank, which would be benefiting the 80% burned skin patient, cancer and major fracture patients, and the small children suffering from heart valve. Salute to these people who have donated the organ in this year and gave life to many people. This is a video.
Accident hua. Wo ladka mar raha tha, isliye uska heart mujhe diya. वो लड़के ने मुझे जीवन दान दिया, उसका मैं धन्यवाद करता हूँ. उसके माता पिताजी, दो माता पिताजी हो गए. मैं ऐसा बोलता हूँ, उसका धन्यवाद मैं बोलता हूँ. हमारा हार्ट सूरत से विमान से आया, अब हमारा हार्ट बहुत अच्छा है. इसलिए बोलता हूँ कि मैं नीलेश मंडे वाले का आशीर्वाद लेता हूँ कि हमको हार्ट दिया. धन्यवाद
दोस्तों. बस हमें जो काम करना है वो हमारे लिए नहीं करना है. ये जो व्यक्ति है जो ऑर्गन फेलियर से पीड़ा से गुजर रहे हैं, वो हमसे अपेक्षा रखते हैं. हम जैसे सारे लोगों के से अपेक्षा रखते हैं कि कुछ ना कुछ करे जिनकी वजह से उनको एक नई लाइफ मिल पाए. एट लास्ट आई विश जस्ट से डोनेट ऑर्गन सेव लाइफ डोनेट लाइफ. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू नीरव. You are doing excellent work, excellent presentation. Ladies and gentlemen, you have seen that in this session, all the innovators are young. They are trying to become the entrepreneur. They do not know how to become the entrepreneur. You know, they need more than financial support, they need your support. It's a mentoring support, more than mentoring, it's a guidance, specific guidance they need from all of you. No innovation, you know, what they presented, can go to masses until unless a good networking is not there. So today they got the golden opportunity that the people from diverse background are here, and I'm sure they would be helpful in specific purpose. like the innovators who have the technological background, they do not know, in fact, how to do the manufacturing. When the bulk orders are there, then who will do the manufacturing for them? I'm sure some of you can help. Aesthetic look, definitely. Quality control and regulatory clearance also. Ultimately, ethics we have to follow. We have to follow the law of land. And in financial transactions also, like lots of lawyers, chartered accountants, and others can help them. I was discussing with them, in fact, and most of them were expecting the mentoring and guidance from all of you. Thank you very much.
If you could please give a couple of minutes and stay there. Thank you. Once again, I'll not try to summarize any of what Dr. Vipin already summarized. So please. We'll start with Mr. Jawad Patel. So sorry, I think the photographer demands that you could. Thank you. Thank you. Mr. Arup Datta. Ms. Dhanashree Chauhan. Master Shubh Dholkia. And sir, big round of applause for the youngest one here today. Thank you. Mr. Yogesh Malkhare and thank you. Ms. Tania Ekaporia. Mr. Nirav Mandlewala. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Mr. Karandikar, if I could request you to please stay here, and I thank all the panelists. Thank you so much. It'll come. Thank you. Okay. Please, Mr. Karandikar, if you could stay here. May I request on stage for the last session of the day, Dr. Mashilkar, as well as Mr. Pradhan, if you could please, sir, come on the stage. We'll do the last session today, which will have both. We'll take some CSR feedback from the audience, as well as we'll talk about the way forward and vote of thanks. So allow us a few more minutes and we'll be able to conduct this last session. So here is the format of it. This is the session where we'll try to take some feedback. We had many CSR representatives coming, especially from them, but from others as well, most welcome. The idea is they have seen many, many such projects of social innovation in their own careers and in their own organizations. They have seen some today. It'll be really great if they mention if there are any specifics that they have liked, that they would like to connect with. That's most welcome. We're not exactly looking at going as far as someone committing anything here and now. I mean, that's like, that's not exactly the objective. But the idea is if you're able to take the discussion forward and decide on here are a couple of examples that you'd like to connect with, and then validate to take that forward, that's going to be really, really great. You know, so that's the objective of doing this. Like we did it last year, we'll be mentioning each of these names because that could go easy. And if you'd like to mention any feedback that you'd like, that's most welcome. And then we could move on to the next guest. So we could first go to, and I'll be requesting to raise the hand if you are around, as I mentioned, the names among the CSR representatives, so that we could go around in the audience. Ms. Aarti Dandavate from Persistent Systems Limited. If you're around, just raise the hand so that Mike could come to you. If not, then we could kind of move to the next one. We have Ms. Bharti Deshpande from Tata Consultancy Services. Yeah, sure. So if you could, Tejas, move the mic to Bharti, she'll be able to give the feedback and we could move then.
Thank you. First thing I would like to say is I'm very happy to be part of this session today organized by NCSI and the PIC. I thank the organizers and the innovators especially. They were just very original and I feel the need that they should be taken forward in the rural areas. We at Tata Consultancy Services, we have a lot of our presence in the rural areas. I would like to mention Mr. Krishna Rajagopal, the D-Hive, Rural Innovation Studio. I liked it very much, and I would definitely like to connect with him in future. for taking this forward in the rural communities. That's it. Wow. Thank you very much, and I thank all the innovators. They were just superb. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Bharti. Great round of applause for Bharti, and we'll move to the next one. Before I go to the next CSR representative, we also have amongst us Commodore Anand Khandekar, who is a member of PIC, and he's advisor to various institutions. One of those is also the STP in Pune, and he could talk about how STP could connect with social innovators. Commodore Khandekar.
Thanks, Prashant. STP stands for Science and Technology Park, which is an institution located in the university campus, Pune, and funded by the Science and Technology Ministry from the center. They run an incubator. They have a number of spaces for incubator. They give seed funding for innovators. They run pilot projects of the products which are produced by the incubating companies, such as solar power, lab. You get a complete sense of movement from an innovator to an entrepreneur. The city of Pune also adds a few more institutions, which I'll just quickly mention. Bhau Institute of Innovation and Incubation, which is about to come up in the COEP campus. Their director is here. He was attending the show, Jeet Vijay, probably he would be here as well. All right. The other institution from IIM Ahmedabad is Center for Innovation and Incubation, again, run by Manish Bhandari. They give incubating space as well as accelerator funding. We have MCCI Pune, which, of course, has been supporting industry at different levels and can support manufacturing of the products which have been mentioned. We have TAI Pune. TAI stands for the Indus Entrepreneur, which really gives entrepreneurial training or mentoring support to the innovators as required. And last but not the least, we have organizations like Product Design Studios. We have Satish Gokhale designing the UE biosciences product. So this is the ecosystem which the city of Pune provides for all the innovators to be turned into entrepreneurs. Thank you.
Thank you, Commodore Khandekar. If I could move on, I'm mentioning names. The whole objective is to kind of move quickly, but very, very happy if one of you do not necessarily have the comment. You know, the whole idea is not to kind of push and force anything. We'll have the next one is Ms. Beena Joshi from Forbes Marshall. If you're around here, thank you. And Tejas, if you could pass the mic. The idea is to take feedback from each one of you quickly so that we could gauge how you felt and what you got out of it.
First of all, thank you for inviting us. It has been a great learning and sharing experience. I think we should admit it very frankly that it's not that CSR knows everything. We also know quite less, so I think that's an eye-opener. And we can probably partner with the innovators to add value to similar programs that we are already operating on the field. Thank you very much.
We'll move on to the Tata Trust. By any chance, if we have Ms. Deepthi Reddy still here, because I know that some of them requested us and they had to move for their flights. So we'll move on. And Mr. Deepanjan Bandopadhyay from Petronet LNG. I'll be going through the names as and when we'll find someone we'll be able to take the feedback. Mr. Girish Ganawat from MQR Pharmaceuticals. Mr. Sitaram Gupta from Lupin. Okay, we'll have Mr. Vinayak Kelkar for sure, because I can see him from Praj.
But it was definitely a great learning, and though there was not much of interaction with the innovators, I had few suggestions on this. One is this thing that what is the expectation of the innovators, if slightly can be highlighted more, because it will give us more chance to know what is the requirement and faster access to the innovator. Of course, a lot of things have come up there apart from the financial things, but especially when we are talking of mentoring and what is the requirement, I think that that area if can be defined. So one is the financial part and other is the qualitative part, that's a mentoring. Secondly, we would like to associate with the tribal innovators and especially the people from BIF and the other things, especially on conservation of germplasm. That is our something dear to our heart. Sure. And we will certainly either do some mentoring or try to develop something more beyond that.
Sure.
And try to help that. And also connect that innovation to our existing program of preventive healthcare, where we are also promoting kitchen gardens. Thank you.
Sure, it's Ruchi here, if you could pass on.
Hi, thank you for arranging this very useful event. I want to share that last year I was here and I actually got to know about the work that the Asra is doing in the field of entrepreneurship and have subsequently partnered with them, you know, for a couple of initiatives. So that's a tangible benefit that arose. And this year I've already, you know, been chatting with my CSR team because I think I Love Composting is very relevant, and as well as the work that Dr. Jog is doing in the area of mental health. So that's just some of the takeaways. There are many others which people have already articulated. In terms of a suggestion, my only suggestion is if there could be maybe a space and time created for exchange and for these connections, you know, just like literally a time slot for that. And if people have cards and, you know, what innovator of dash dash, and, you know, so it's easy to know who's an innovator, who's a CSR head, and connect. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Colonel Deshmukh. I'm from Mahindra Vehicles Manufacturing Limited, and I look after the CSR. We have really enriched ourselves by joining you and understanding how everything is functioning here. Thank you for this opportunity. We would take it upon ourselves to interact with various people who have shown various innovation.
Jeet Vijay here, who is CEO of Bhau Institute. They run an incubation center. Jeet, if you have any comments on.
Dr. Mashalkar, sir, only you could do this. And it's such an inspiration to be in the company with you and all the eminent personalities here. And, you know, it's fascinating what you have done to showcase the talent that we have in our rural, tribal, and even in the urban innovations. And as part of this community, it is incumbent upon us to take forward what you have launched, right? As we were talking earlier, Kay, especially with the winner here, Mihir. So one thing we would like to say is that, you know, of course, Bhau Institute is going to be a home for you. So if you need, you know, space and opportunity to collaborate, we'd love to discuss that. Because just to give a brief background on Bhau Institute, it's an institute for innovation, entrepreneurship, and leadership created under College of Engineering, Pune. And Mashalkar sir is on our executive council, along with Commander Khandekar sir, and Atul Kirloskar sir, Pratap Pawar sir, and bunch of community leaders in Pune. And this is by the entrepreneurs for the entrepreneurs. So our goal is to support new generation of entrepreneurs, and not just the high-tech one, but the social entrepreneurs as well. So we are trying to do as much as we can, and wherever possible, if any CSR organization wants to collaborate with us or any way we can help and facilitate, we'll love to do that. So Mahir, in your case, so we'll be happy to first of all offer, you know, opportunity for you to, you know, do things in Pune. And second is we'll love to connect you to the investors in the Boston and New York area, since, you know, I was in there for the last 17, 18 years. And Mount Sinai Hospital or the Kettering Memorial, though they're cancer focused, but in the Boston, you know, the VC funding community, plus the Texas community, Texas Medical Center in Houston, and all the Texas Central Texas Angel Network. So we're happy to facilitate those conversations for your funding, plus the local investors in India. So we'll be happy to do that. Aside from this, for all the other, you know, entrepreneurs that showcased here today, we are here and we are available. We'll be happy to sit down with you, discuss with you on how we can facilitate your dreams come true, because that's the only mission we have under SIR's leadership and guidance, is to, you know, wherever we can help, we'll do that. And one last quick point, when Khandekar sir mentioned the ecosystem in Pune, one important element they forgot to mention was the venture center at NCL. So that's a very critical, especially for life science companies, and I'm sure Premnath sir, we will be very happy, and Manish ma'am, to see, you know, how they can support these companies. So Pune is a very proactive ecosystem, so all of you, and Prashant will share the details, so you can share with the entrepreneurs, and we'll do what we can to support them.
We'll take the last comment before we progress. We'll just take the fag end of it. We'll take that comment, and we'll then be able to progress to the next section of it. That's fair. We all are very, very ordinary. and that's absolutely fine.
Thank you very much. It was a great experience. When I was going through with this whole event, it was quite a good learning for me. And thank you very much for this. I have few points as I belong to media fraternity. I was just observing, and this is just my point of view, maybe right, maybe wrong. I was just wondering if NCSI can tie up with some media company. Specifically, if I have to say, then with some radio company, Radio Mirchi, Radio City, and all this, because ultimately, at the end of the day, we need to celebrate the concept of innovation. So as long as it is out of this group where we are sitting, if everyone from Pune or outside Pune also can learn about that, what is happening, what kind of things is there, maybe some good jingle about some innovator come on the radio, I would be more happy to listen this. So that is my first suggestion. Second, I would like to share that, like we have great dignitaries, so about them, common audience would be interested to know. Suppose Mashalkar sir ke baare mein yadi koi jingle banti hai ya unke lifestyle ke barate the, mereko acha lagega sunne ke liye. To mereko lagta hai ye cheez pahunchni chahiye. Teesra cheez mereko lagta hai ki success story jo hamare yahan ke innovators ne itni batai hai, ye yadi logo tak pahunchane ka to hum media ko kaisa use kar sakte hain, aur wo media ko use karte hue yadi humne unke choti choti video clips yahan se ban rahi hai, isko yadi WhatsApp pe leke logo tak pahunchaya to bhi usse bahut benefit hoga. Last point mereko ye bolna hai ki यहाँ पे अवार्ड वगैरह का भी यदि प्रचलन है तो वो होना चाहिए, और पब्लिक चॉइस अवार्ड भी रहे तो इससे लोगों को भी आइडिया आएगा कि कौन सी आइडिया किसको ज़्यादा अच्छी लग रही है. और बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया, बहुत मज़ा आया, बहुत सीखने को मिला. मैं साइंस बैकग्राउंड से नहीं हूँ, थोड़ा ऊपर से जाता है, लेकिन इतना समझ में आता है कि क्या क्या चीज़ें हो रही है. सो थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू सो मच. मेनी मेनी थैंक्स. आई थिंक रियली रियली अप्रिशिएट. अपोलॉजीज, वी आर नॉट एबल टू टेक लॉट मेनी मोर, बट मेनी ऑफ यू हैव टॉक्ड टू अस इन द ब्रेक्स एंड विल कीप ऑल ऑफ दैट इन माइंड. थैंक यू फॉर ऑल द गुड विशेस एंड गुड कमेंट्स, बट स्पेशली दोज who were positive and constructive criticisms. We'll take more of those in action, and we'll try to make sure that next year we'll improve in the spirit of continuous improvement. We have a couple of things left to be done before we conclude the program. And while doing PAC program, we always have an eye on the wristwatch just to make sure that we're able to conclude it in time. Before I'll be asking Mr. Satish Pradhan to speak, and the last word would be, of course, with Dr. Mashalkar. So we've made tiny bit of ergonomical change in terms of making the vote of thanks a bit earlier than the last two presentations. So allow us to do that, because then you'd be left with the last word from Dr. Mashalkar, rather than having me to kind of say the vote of thanks at the end of it. Thank you. So it's interesting. There are many, many people to thank. You know, we don't know where to start and where to end, because when we work with association of people or association of organizations, you know, there are a bunch of people you see on the stage, and there are way lot many more people behind the stage making it work. It's always been difficult, but we try to do what we try to do in saying thanks to people who made it all happen. Yesterday, we started with a session from Mr. Vishwas Mahajan, who is a director on the Thai Global Board. He took a couple of hours of session with all the social innovators. Then we had Advocate Wadekar, who did another session on legal aspects of it. We had today Professor Shaban from TIS, we had Mr. Lokhande, Pradeep Lokhande, and of course we had Dr. Vipin Kumar conducting each of these different sessions. We also had a lot of help from BIF team and many other institutions who kind of came together to make it happen. As a tiny, tiny token of appreciation, we are very, very good at giving the token of appreciation, and it's always a book largely, you know. So we have the same book, and fortunately there is no quiz after that. So that's all right. So to begin with, may I invite on stage Mr. Vishwas Mahajan. If you could please come on stage, and I'll be requesting Dr. Mashalkar to please give a token of appreciation to Vishwas. Wonderful and very, very useful for many social innovators. If we have Professor Shaban in the audience, maybe he has left to Tuljapur. Then we'll go to Mr. Pradeep Lokhande. Sir, if you could come. And the claps could go on while Mr. Lokhande kind of runs to the stage. I'll be requesting each one of them to stay on the stage for one quick photo. Thank you, Mr. Lokhande. May I request Dr. Vipin Kumar to please come. Dr. Vipin Kumar is CIO of National Innovation Foundation and co-organizer of the NCSI. Before I invite a couple of PIC members, I know it will be tough, but I have
the morning program, all of this was successful because we could have both Sanid as well as in the background Sushil helping. So Sushil, you know, forgive me and please, I know you don't typically like to come on stage, but you should come on stage, and that's a request to you. Thank you for considering that. Sanid, if you're around. Thank you, Sushil. Sanid, if you're around. Okay, we could have Mr. Karandikar, if you could request you to please give it to. Then we'll request on stage, please, if you could stay for a minute. Sanid, if you could also come along, because that's together we have. We'll be having one copy read between both of you. Come. We'll have the PIC members. I'll be requesting, please, if you could stay around, both of you. We'll be requesting Namita Joshi. You have seen and you have heard her today. Young Namita has joined us recently. So please, if you could stay. Our own team, we said that rather than having the books, we have a copy of the book which we'll all be reading in PIC. So that will take care of it. It's a book by Dr. Vikas Amthe. We'll also be requesting Mr. Amresh Kesare. Amresh, if you could please come up. For the last 2.5 years, Amresh, you've been doing a wonderful job in making sure that all the nuts and bolts of PIC programs work. So thank you for making it work. This year, we had 2 interns from MIT SOG. And both of them did a very, very good job. We'll be requesting both of them. That's Rohan Akhade and Karan Patil. If you could please come. Come, young boys. Mr. Hitendra Singh, if you could please also come. Mr. Hitendra Singh. Hitendra is a friend of mine from IIM Ahmedabad. He's working in Dubai, and he decided to take 3-month gap from his job to work for NCSI. And he's come to Pune to work for 3 months before he goes back to Dubai. Thank you, Hitendra. And Kiran, if you're around anywhere there, Kiran, who manages the entire PIC office. Thank you. Thank you so much. So we'll take, thank you, please. First, we'll have Mr. Satish Pradhan giving his remarks, and then the last word with the President PIC, Dr. Raghunath Mashalkar. Mr. Pradhan.
Good evening to all of you. Thank you very much. Thank you all, innovators, well-wishers, and the CSR community. Deeply indebted to you for having made this event even more special than it has been in the past few years. We noted some of the suggestions, and particularly the one about creating time and space for opportunities to interact with the innovators and a few of the other things that you've mentioned. I just have 2 thoughts which came to me as we went through the day. One was the need, I think, to work with collaboration in terms of intermingling and leveraging ideas to build something more than the original idea had. And the second was collaboration and cooperation amongst the innovators to be able to build scale, impact, and perhaps even cost affordability. Where one element may not have it, the others might. And so I think, to me, the theme was, we're doing great things. We're supporting great things. Can we do a lot more together if we combine some of our ideas and our ways of doing things? Thank you very much once again. And I look forward to seeing a lot of follow-up and some potential interests or expressions of interest taking a more tangible shape. Thank you.
Pradhan, before I invite Dr. Mashalkar, I'll just add in my vote of thanks the people from media, various organizations like Tanishka and the other NGOs and other civil society organizations who came in large numbers. So huge round of applause for all of them. Thank you. And sir, if you could request you to please give your concluding remarks, and we'll close the session after that speech. Thank you.
Well, it's a privilege to have the first word in the morning and the last word now. And I'll begin with what I ended with. I ended by expressing a hope that as we walk out from here, will carry new ideas, there will be new learning. There's a new meaning to our life, new moments that we'll cherish, new connects that we'll make, and new steps that we'll take. I can see that happen already based on the kind of response I've had, I've heard, not only here, but while interacting with others. So it has been a very, very, very special day as far as I'm concerned. What are the moments that will flash when I sleep? You know, I don't sleep very well, by the way. I must tell you, my sleep is about four and five hours. And continuously, there are flashes that keep on coming about the events. So I don't know what are the flashes that I'm going to have today, because there were so many moments, basically. You know, that young Rahul Karad who got a second life, saying, I have two parents now. You know, it touched here, somehow. Yogesh Malkhade, the way he spoke about the challenges that he had, the young man talking about his wish that somebody who has one leg should be able to ride a cycle as well as anybody else. Why should he use a tricycle? So I think it is becoming very clear that it is not just the innovation, as I always say, and it's not just the passion, the compassion that matters. And bulk of the solutions we have seen all the time, whenever there are solutions, they come from compassion, that feeling. You went into cancer because you saw the suffering in your family, including your mother-in-law. And therefore, how do we make use of that compassionate capital to build and reimagine our new India? I think is the issue, honestly. All right? We may be poor in physical capital. We are a poor country. But in terms of compassionate capital, I think we are rich. That's the single message I get from this. I'm not going to be workmanlike and lay out now the timelines and the next steps, etc., etc. But I can't help being a scientist, so I must tell you something. When you talk about bonds, I, as a student, learned two types of bonds. The first are what we call as secondary valence-based bonds, hydrogen bonding, van der Waal forces, where two molecules come together and join temporarily. But little bit of stress, little bit of rise of temperature, and they break away. We call them physical bonds. The other ones are chemical bonds. They're covalent bonds. They don't break. So when I talked about the connects today, I'm hoping that these connects will not be of the first type. They will be permanent, long-ranging, covalent bonds, all right, when we go back from here. As usual, I always talk in terms of making an impact, but making a big impact. And big impact means scale. And how do we sort of scale? How do we reach out to larger and larger and larger number of people? You know, as I said, I'm a compulsory tweeter. So in the morning, when I was sitting there, and as Rahibai was speaking, and you were giving repeated applause. I have never seen scenes like this, by the way, before. You know, it was incredible, the confidence with which she spoke. It was incredible. Her achievements were, of course, incredible, but her confidence was terrific. Not only that, the pulse of wisdom and a sense of humor with which she spoke. No, honestly, I'm telling you, I'm so impressed. In fact, at the end, I went to her and I said, may I have a photograph with you? And I'm cherishing it. Honestly, I'm telling you, I'm going to sort of preserve it. So people call me a dangerous optimist, by the way. Durdamya Ashavadi. Now you know why that dangerous optimism comes. It is because of the Rahibais of this world, the young shoobs of this world who sort of spoke here. I think India is a great country. Don't get bothered by the noise that you see. All right? We are up. We are rising. You know? And that faith gets sort of restored today. And I always like to see, you know, as I'm getting older, I'm playing the fourth innings of my life, the final inning of my life. You keep on adding years to your life, but events like this do add life to your years. So thank you very much.
Thank you so much. That concludes the program today. Thank you.